Need more insight into risks due to uncertain business events? SAP Analytics Cloud's Compass feature uses Monte Carlo simulation with random sampling on your time-based data to help you understand risks and take informed action. You can launch Compass either from the main menu or from a populated table in a story. When you launch Compass from the main menu, you start your simulation by specifying settings such as the model you want to work with and the target measure or account you're interested in. You then add filters as necessary to define your business question. A date-based filter is mandatory. When you launch Compass from a table cell, the initial details for the simulation are taken directly from the table. The cell you start from defines the time period of interest, the version, and the range of drivers that will be available for you to work with in the simulation. Keep in mind that Compass simulations need to be based on measures that are based on a calculation. For example, by choosing net income as the starting point, all the accounts that contribute to net income will be available as drivers so that you can explore how variations in one or more of those values could affect the total. If you choose a measure that isn't calculated based on other accounts, such as gross revenue, no drivers are available because the measure doesn't need to be calculated. Here, a private scenario has been created, and all the drivers that contribute to net income are available to work with. Filters have been defined based on the version and time period of the cell selected in the table. You can add additional filters to restrict the scenario, such as including only the data for a particular customer or product. Next, you can choose the range of drivers you want to include in the simulation. Keep in mind that the only drivers that affect the outcome of the simulation are those for which you add variability to the values, so it's not strictly necessary to disable or remove ones you aren't interested in. You can reduce the range of drivers by removing them from the list individually, disabling them individually, or enabling multi-select checkboxes, and activating, deactivating, or removing multiple drivers at once. You can choose what information appears for each driver. By default, filters and baseline values are shown, but there are options to show the measure name and distribution options for each driver. For each driver, you have the option to add a restricted driver by applying a filter. For example, you might apply a filter to restrict the variability to a specific product or product range. The baseline reflects the current value for the driver. To see how variations in sales deductions could affect the target of net income, you can specify minimum and maximum values that define the range you want to simulate. Simulations use a normal distribution by default, meaning that 99.7% of data falls within three standard deviations of the mean value. The uniform distribution option means that all values in the value range are equally likely to occur. By leaving the payroll driver without minimum and maximum values, you can run the simulation using the current baseline value. Next, you can choose how to run the scenario, with options that run the simulation 1,000, 10,000, or 100,000 times. The graph shows the probability distribution of the driver's impact on the target. The x-axis represents the target value, and the y-axis shows the probability. Vertical lines represent the boundaries that divide all likely outcomes into three cases, with the displayed percentages indicating the probability of achieving a value within each range. Here you can see that the realistic case for net income is between 34 and 62 million, with a 5% chance of an outcome below the range and a 5% chance of a result above the range. The current baseline is still within the realistic case, but there is a higher likelihood of achieving a value above than below it. To explore the chances of achieving values above or below a specific target value, you can move the slider or manually enter a value. When you're finished, you can save the private scenario, and optionally publish it to make it available to other users. Keep in mind that when you publish a scenario, users can view the list of drivers, but not edit them. Finally, if you want, you can create additional scenarios using the existing one as a starting point. Now you can edit the scenario details to explore different combinations of drivers or ranges of values. For more information on how to work with Compass in SAP Analytics Cloud, check out the links in the description and try it for yourself today.